Hello and welcome back to the Leander 98 channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at this Xmods Evolution 2019 Chevrolet Impala Premier. This is not an OEM body and was made just for this chassis. This body was printed in one piece on my Anycubic Photon Mono X, printed in this orientation that you see here. It was all in one piece, as well as the fact that this uses my old wing mirror design, so that didn't even need any supports right there, which is great, and especially for racing here, considering that the mirrors are nice and tucked into the windows so they can't get knocked off. Granted, they don't look the most realistic, but that's okay for now. For this specific body, I'll be running it on a 98mm long chassis with the G35 front clip on it. The main body that came on this chassis was the G35 and the 2005 Ford Mustang. But many cars in the street branded Xmods use this chassis length as well. I'm using this clip as my standard, as it is the shortest clip in length, so it makes bodies easier to model for. I'll be dubbing this the sedan slash luxury coupe class, as this chassis has some length to it, and some SUVs may also fit on this chassis in case of not wanting to be moved to a full truck chassis. This chassis being on the longer side may cause it to understeer a bit if not handled correctly. Throwing the body on the scale here, we see that it weighs 43 grams, which is pretty light for how big this body is. Must have some pretty thin walls. Granted, it has no aero bits on it, so there's not really any extensions that can make it weigh a lot. Throwing it on the split scales, we see that we have a weight balance of 25 at the rear and 18 in the front. A pretty average car body, I should say. Nothing real exciting going on here with this one, so we'll have to see how it turns out. As we set the chassis down onto the scale, we see that the bare chassis itself with batteries weighs 190 grams. The front weight distribution is 48 grams on the passenger side and 39 grams on the driver's side. For the rear, it's 46 grams on the driver's side and 56 grams on the passenger side. Not the most balanced of chassis, but considering we take a lot more left-hand corners than right-hand corners, having more weight on the right-hand side might not be a bad idea. This chassis looks heavily modified in terms of its electronics, and it is, but nothing has been modified in terms of the voltage going to the motor, so it runs at a very healthy 18 kilometers per hour. The extra 3.7 volt LiPo that gets plugged in is directly into the receiver to fuel the steering servo, as the ESC tends to cut off the steering sometimes when it's hungry for voltage. The whole point of this is to run hobby electronics and use a proper controller instead of the junk OEM one. This episode of Body Shell Reviews isn't sponsored, but I would like to give a shout out to a brilliant artist known as Hakasuka Works. Based out of Australia, he makes his living creating your dream ride in nostalgic cel-shaded graphics. We found each other through this Seiko XS that he has created here, and I myself even got the Gina Special and asked for the City Turbo from Midnight Club 2. He offers commissions starting at $125. Maybe just interested in seeing his museum of cars? Give his Instagram or Twitter a look at Hakasuka Works.
Whoa, jeez.
Wrong controller.
Ooh. Oh, alright.
Bring in the pit. Jeez, this car handled. Can't get the steering right. Oh well.
Alright, let's take a look at the timesheet for this car. As we can see, we had a fastest lap of 7.146. That's pretty fast considering the lack of aero on this car, and I'm being about 0.1 seconds slower than the TRD Avalon. Yeah, we were faster than the Jetta, but that one we kind of had a water handicap, so that one doesn't necessarily count. Though our median time isn't exactly the best, but that's because we had a few stops to where we had to adjust the controller just because, well, the steering just didn't feel centered. So, tried adjusting, didn't work, tried adjusting, maybe it still wasn't right, but we still had a good lap around the track. We got 28 laps around the track as well. I don't think we had a major crash. So, other than that, I think we did pretty good.
One last thing before we close here on this video. If you like the cars that you saw in this video, take a look at the link down in the description. It'll take you to my Cults 3D page where you can download the STL file for just $1. That $1 will get you a dummy chassis and the body in resin printing and FDM plastic printing as well. Let's say so that you can print it whether or not you have a plastic printer that you want to use for racing, or maybe you got a resin printer that you want to use extra detail for. Either way, your taste, you can download the car that you saw in this video today on my Cults 3D page that's down in the link in the description below. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. And if you're new, subscribe for more RC driving content here. That's quite a few different things that we do on this channel here, so I apologize if it's never one exact thing. Until next time, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.
Ooh.
Ooh, come on. Tire's catching on something, isn't it? Whoa, jeez. Too much now. Ooh, rough. Wrong controller. Ooh. Oh. Oh, that's all it. Oh, all right. Bring it in the pits. Jeez, this car handled. Can't get the steering right. Oh, well.